great to have you watching CNN Student News. This is our second to last show of the school year. I'm Carl Azus, and I'm glad to bring it to you.
Time for the shout out. Where would you find the line, water, water everywhere, nor any drop to drink? You know what to do. Is it in The Rime of the Ancient Mariner, Moby Dick, The Old Man and the Sea, or Seabiscuit? You've got 3 seconds. Go. Coleridge's Rime of the Ancient Mariner has this line about being surrounded by seawater. None of it drinkable. That's your answer, and that's your shout out.
Of course, if those sailors had only been able to desalinate that water to take the salt out of it, then they could have drunk it. The basic process of converting seawater to drinking water is ancient, but doing this on a large scale is difficult and expensive. The fact that more than 70% of Earth is covered by ocean inspires scientists to keep on trying.
With California experiencing one of the worst droughts in the state's history, access to fresh water has never been more important or more difficult. Here in Southern California, the largest desalination plant in the Western Hemisphere is being constructed. It will soon take water from the ocean and create 50 million gallons of fresh water a day.
California is in a serious drought right now, and any new water supplies are important to the region.
We have a $190 billion economy in this region that's dependent on water. The question you need to consider is, what's the cost of not having enough water?
Unlike, let's say, water that comes from rainfall or water that comes from snowpack, we're utilizing what essentially is the world's largest reservoir, the Pacific Ocean.
The Carlsbad desalination plant will cost approximately $1 billion. The fresh water will be pumped 10 miles underground to a regional delivery system, providing water to an additional 300,000 San Diego County residents.
Customers, they won't know whether they're drinking desalinated water or not.
That's right. That's right. It'll just become part of the overall supply.
Through a process called reverse osmosis, the plant will convert every 2 gallons of seawater into 1 gallon of fresh water, filtering out 99.9% of the salt. The salt, or brine, that's removed is discharged back into the ocean. The desalination process traditionally takes a lot of energy. A plant this size would normally use as much energy in a single day as 70 homes in a year. Officials at the Carlsbad plant say theirs will use 46% less energy. The project is not without criticism. Environmentalists point out that desalination requires a lot of energy, and that brine discharge can negatively impact marine life.
So we're creating more marine wetlands at the south end of San Diego Bay to create new habitat so fish can reproduce there. With respect to the brine discharge, we dilute the brine with seawater before it leaves the site.
The plant is expected to be completed in 2016.
And everybody is extremely excited to see this project coming online and providing us with a new water supply.